Mind T-Pain from ImpatientProgrammer.net. This is PySide and PyQt Q-Widgets in 3 minutes. We're talking about front windows, back windows, round, dirty, broken. If only Windows operating system worked as well as my bedroom window. Oh, me. Alright, QWidget is the simplest of all window types, and the base class other UI stuff inherits from. QWidget is the first of the four window classes I'll be showing. Windows themselves are just the empty shell of an application, tool, or whatever you're making. Most everything your user interacts with will be contained or launched from this generated user interface, or GUI, or UI, or whatever you want to call it. It has a title, a minimize, maximize, and close buttons at the top, and then everything else within the main window here. So let's look at this simple example here. We start out by importing Qt widgets from our qt.py file placed immediately next to our current working file. Again, qt.py allows for us to develop for PyQt 4, PyQt 5, PySide, and PySide 2 simultaneously without having to change our code. Check out the previous resources tutorial for more on this. If you're looking to create a button layout or whatever and need to know what module it is in the qt.py file, simply open the file, search for what you want, and you'll find the module that it is a part of after you scroll forever right there. We then import sys. We then instance qApplication, which allows all of our UI code to work. Next, we create an instance of our qWidget with a title of ham and show it. I've commented out a line after to show you how you can set the window title to something else if you so desire right here. So if we were to run this, we would see the title is called ham. If we uncomment this line out here and rerun, it'll be called ham2 now. We then call show once for the whole window, otherwise it will remain hidden. Finally, we tell the system to exit when the application has finished executing. And now I'd like to go over some important QWidget documentation. Here's some important window functions and methods. Size is great for getting the size info for a window or widget. Resize can be used to set the width and height of a window. Pose can get the screen space position. I often use this when saving and loading settings to the window to keep it where the user likes our tool or application. It's a quality of life feature that's nice. Set modality. Set if the window needs to be on top of others. Set window icon. Set the top left window icon as well as the taskbar icon. Set window title. Sets the window's title, of course. And show, we've gone over. Now here are some important widget functions. Set tooltip. A tooltip when the user mouses over a widget. Set what is this? Here you can place miscellaneous data, mostly hidden from the user, but still a part of the UI. I've used it to store weird ID numbers and strings. Some applications and even dialogues will have a little question mark in the top right next to your close button. If you click that, then some object, it will bring up that what's this info. Set style sheet. Sets the CSS style or look of the widget and all of its children. Set enabled. This is how you lock and unlock widgets or even the whole window. Set hidden. This is how you show or hide widgets or even the whole window. Excellent work. Exercises are in the description and following this video. If you would like to see a practical application built from scratch, check out my tool development series linked in the description. Thank you to all my wonderful patrons, and as always, like, subscribe, and keep the dream alive.